Me why? You either ride or die. If I got to get to leave, is it a lie? Can two roads make a right? Is it okay when pigeons are so strong? I was tired many times they die.
So,
nothing clear yet, but if it's Honduras, I'm a pro. I can handle it.
Well, I told you he's not onto any of us.
Not Marcus. He's either looking for a nightman or already found one.
Why are you so certain?
Because the man who ordered your father killed is not about to call it quits just because I'm protecting his daughter.
Isn't this so absurd?
What?
You killed my father, and here you are protecting me.
Please.
What?
Look, I'm only a pro doing my job.
Then why didn't you do the same job on me?
Don't push me.
Well, you think I care?
Don't give a damn if you care or not.
Then let me out of here. God! Why isn't anyone listening to me? I need to get back to the States.
All right. I killed your father. But it's now my duty to protect you and Pretty. So, you don't move until I tell you to do so.
Just who the hell are you?
Mommy.
Sweetheart, you're awake. Come. Kiss, kiss.
Superman, that's you, right? I got you, right? Drop that gun! Drop that shit! Superman! Your hands up? I want to see your hands up. Up! I said up!
what?
Well, listen, I've got a confirmation.
What confirmation?
There. He's got an assassin.
Oh,
one with a sniper's instinct and damn good.
So, how does he help?
Well, a great deal of knowing what we're up against is halfway through the problem, eh?
So, what are we gonna do?
Well, leave here first. Because he's a professional and he knows we're here ready.
What are we leaving for?
Safe place for at least for 48 hours.
And after that?
Well, one at a time, okay? But first, I must find out who wants to kill me. Okay?
Here, $50,000 ticket.
So, what do you want me to do? Kill my own mother?
I'm not that kind of a sucker. I know you killed your mother 25 years ago.
Hardly my fault.
You save your grief for another sucker.
So what do you want?
Marcus. Fred Marcus. He has a contract on my head. I want to know everything about the man on the job.
Oh, that? Give me 2 minutes.
We gotta get better.
Then if it's that good, he will definitely find out this hideout.
That's exactly what I'm saying. We're moving out in 24 hours.
God! Why don't I just get off this dog chase and fly out with my daughter?
Because you're a target as much as I am. And for your information, they got $100,000 on our heads to knock us off.
Why are we sticking together anyway? It is good for you who can shoot back. But with my daughter, I am a sitting duck.
You are safe as long as I stay alive.
How?
Because you're a bait to smoke me out. In the professional handbook, that's what we do. We use the known to get to the unknown. You know what I'm saying? And I can go on the ground, you know, mix with the crowd and dissolve. Whew. But you can't.
Then let me fly out while you're still alive.
Come on, Mario. He's not a fool. Look, immediately you make that move, man, he's going to kill you, man, and come for me.
God, this is crazy.
Or curse your luck for being the daughter of who you are.
Well, I don't care anymore.
Oh, you should. For your daughter's sake. Look, I'm only trying to help you, okay? So you better hang in there. I'm gonna do something.
I'm going to trap them all. Warn after the author and kill them all. All right? Including Marcus. So, you wouldn't have to live in fear of the assassin's bullet anymore.
So, what do I do?
Whatever I tell you to.
And what exactly are you telling me to do?
Mariel, please, just go get some sleep, you know, relax, rest. You might not be as lucky as you are tomorrow night.
I hope you all know the caliber of a man we are up against. From now on, you have to be on your toes and constantly watch your backs. The element of surprise is gone forever. You take it from me. There are no more safety nets. We have lost Mark to a man we surprised.
Papa, don't kill this woman, Tetiru. I don't know why you kick against her.
Now you listen to me and you listen good. This woman is the bait. You kill her and Skippo disappears. He comes back and pick each of you like pigeons. And guess what? It ends between us. So long as this woman is alive, he is potentially vulnerable.
So, make we just a Zuzu the follow up and down like that?
Exactly like you said. All we need to do is we have to strike him through her. First thing, we have to get his new abode. You feel me?
Come on in.
Come on.
Now sit. Sit down.
Come on. What was that just happened out there?
The amateur's instinct.
And who was in that car behind us?
Well, I paid him 50,000 naira.
To die?
Hazards of the profession.
God. Why did you do it?
What?
That crazy stuff you call the amateur's instinct.
We are dealing with a professional who knows all the rules in the professional handbook. And to beat him, we need to use the amateur's instincts. Get it?
And what exactly does that mean?
Mariel. The amateur is one who does not know anything in the professional handbook. And does not play by the rules. Alright? I mean, he shoots when he shouldn't and runs when he should be still. Moving in a car in the dark with the lights on is a crazy thing to do. And no professional would employ that to duck a bullet from an assassin. Get it? And it worked.
Why are you doing this?
Because it's a game I enjoy. And besides, I owe you one.
That was crazy! That was completely useless! That was useless!
What's the problem?
He was using the amateur instincts.
Amateur instincts?
Yes, you heard me. Doing the unexpected. And that means playing with total disregard to the books.
In other words, being more professional, right?
Now, what do we want to do now?
We smoke him! We smoke him out, okay? So long as he keeps with the woman and the kid, he is vulnerable. Come on, let's get out. Come on, move it! Move it, now!
if you're stressed out.
Sir, we have been here earlier, but for this heavy hold of under.
Yeah, drink. That's what you always do in my house. Drink. So, how is your assassin doing?
From every indication, he's covering grounds.
Covering grounds?
Sure.
By losing two men already.
Hazards of the profession. Camille is your best bet if you really want Skippo dead. Make no mistake about that.
You bet I do.
Then don't scare your blood vents. The man will surely deliver.
He better delivers. I'm getting very impatient.
He will.
That guy escaped for that hotel room.
I know.
You know?
Sure, Tiger, I know that.
How?
The professional instinct. Found only in the assassin's logbook.
What the hell is that son of a bitch?
I will soon find out.
I can't wait. We've lost Mark and Ludo. And the next person can be me.
Now you listen to me. You have survived. Okay? We are dealing with the best since the jackal. This guy is crafty. He read the books. He lives on trees. He lives on rooftops. And he has knocked more men than you've had quickies.
What did that guy want to say in himself? In a god.
It's the devil.
Okay, make what they see now.
So, why did we get this car?
Survival instincts.
Survival instinct?
That's right.
It's obvious and draws a lot of attention.
Hey, look, Camille will never look out for a car like this.
So, where are we going?
I'm taking the fight to him.
What?
That's right.
Then let me out of here!
Look, as long as you stay with me, you'll live!
I am no longer enjoying any bit of this.
God, no one enjoys war until you get entangled in it.
Why must we take the fight to him?
Because if we do not get him, he will get me and consequently you.
Shop, you still get plenty days here.
I want to go home. I want to go home.
You don't get any house.
I'm risking your life for that.
Never know anything. No. How much longer do we wait?
Me, I don't want this job to come do nani.
We're both going for him. He's going to be here and we get him.
So which time he won't come now?
He's a pro tiger. He's going to be here.
See, make I tell you. We don't miss Ludo and Mark. And the one with the payment pass now, Nazita. You know which are the thing?
That you are the next.
Bam.
You know what, Tiger? You play your role according to my script, and then you live to be 100 years.
So, waiting be the next scene for your script?
Waiting.
You got to do better than this, alright?
You know what, Tiger? I was taught waiting is the best form of suspense, and you better get that into your skull. And come on, you put some bullets into this shit. Come on.
Go ahead, come on.
I only came here to bury Daddy and got entangled in a web only formerly imagined in Hollywood screens.
Well, that's the life we're leaving, you know. Must always stop for true life stories.
So how do I get my daughter back?
Waiting.
Waiting?
Sure.
God, what if something happens to Pretty?
Nothing's gonna happen to her.
She's now his trump card. He's gonna feed her well, pamper her, and expect me to make a quick grab at her.
But we must go for Pretty immediately.
That's what he expects us to do.
So, why wait?
Because he's ready. Look. Waiting for me to make just that move. It's a mind game. Mariel, one slip, and there's no safety net.
So, what do we do?
Like I said, we wait.
Now tell me, why didn't you kill me when you already had the contract money?
I'd rather we skip that.
No. If we have to wait this game out with my own daughter as the bait around the hook dangling beneath the sinker, then we have to discuss it now.
Jesus! Jesus! Please, please, please don't kill me, please. Please don't kill me, please. Please, please. My baby, please. Please, please. Please save my baby, please. Please, please. 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 Jesus!
Jesus Christ!
Yeah. I went to Liberia, man, you know? I went to Liberia as a peacekeeper in the force, man. Well, my own family burned. I caught the animal. But because I wanted the Lord to take his course, I handed him over to the police. Otherwise, I would have killed that idiot with my bare hands.
This is
the same government I went thousands of miles away to serve.
collaborating with a gunman to wipe away my whole direct family.
The government?
Yeah, sure. The killing was political. My father, he got in the way, so it was time to pay back.
This is unbelievable.
I know. But it's true. Immediately, I picked up my rifle and became an assassin. I got all of them involved, including the judge, and I knocked them all off.
But two wrongs don't make a right.
But anyway, I became a professional hitman. Because I lost my own family, man. Damn. My source of joy. My source of joy. Nothing mattered to me anymore.
But two wrongs can't make a right.
That's theoretical. In real life, vengeance can be soothing.
So,
that night, when I had my rifle pointed at you, the sudden appearance of your daughter changed everything. At that moment, it dawned on me like my family 5 years ago that you and your daughter needed protection. So I employed myself.
Damn! You're one hell of a gunman.
You're one hell of a daughter. And tell me, why would your father come in the crosshairs of my sniper's telescope?
It's a long story.
Oh, well, we got all night. Listen, why don't you tell me, why would you entrust yourself to a man who killed your father to protect you?
The last bit is simple. I saw you squeeze the trigger and pop the bullet over my head. It was a gamble I had to take. Not that I had a choice, though, with the other group itching dangerously close.
It was a matter of convenience, is it?
More or less.
Wait, no, I'm listening.
Yes, Daddy.
Yes, Maria. I called you because I want to let you into one secret.
What secret, Daddy?
$50 million. A certain $50 million.
$50 million?
Yes. But I have a partner. A partner in crime, you may call it.
What are you saying? A partner in crime?
You don't seem to understand why our economy is crumbling every day, do you?
It's obvious. Mismanagement, of course.
My daughter, looting is the appropriate word.
So what happened to the $50 million?
Yes, I was working as an accountant.
But Daddy, that was years ago.
Yes, precisely 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
There was this supplier and general contractor. But before that time, the chief executive of NEPA went by the name Marcos. As is usual in government agencies, we struck a deal and faked some invoices and wired $50 million to a pre-numbered account in Zurich.
What?
Yes, but the SSS got nosy and asked some questions. So we decided to stay action. We instructed the Swiss bank through our agents here, the Ultimate Bank, to stay action. Both of us devised a secret code, not known to each one of us. And we have to feed this secret code into the computer every month. And in the event of one becoming dormant, the other person takes over.
Why such absurd agreement?
My daughter, one has to agree to something.
So?
It was a sworn secret between Marcos and me. You see, Marcos has no relations. And he believes I don't have one either.
In other words, you deceived him.
Yes, because he wouldn't have done the business with me in the first place.
So why tell me now after 10 years?
Yes. You see, Marcos is in the hole. His business has beaten the dust. And he wants to grab the money. I've been holding him back all this while because this is just one move that the SSS are waiting for.
I don't understand. Why corner such amount of money when you cannot even spend it?
One, it gives you a great sense of pleasure to know that you have such amount of money, even if you can't spend it. Secondly, I mean, a friendly government may come up one day and the SSS may decide to look the other way. I'm an accountant, mind you. Never in a hurry.
In the meantime,
Marcos is desperate. He wants to kill me and inherit the account in the event of my inactivity for 6 months.
So, how do you intend to stop him?
Yes, by giving you the secret code which you must feed into the computer every first Monday of every month. In case if anything happens to me.
So, you provided the bullets?
Well, hardly my fault. I mean, I was only a professional trying to earn a living.
No grudges. My father lived a risky life. He was expecting it anyway.
So, who's Pretty's father? And you married? Divorced?
None of your business.
Forgive me.
Please.
What?
Um
I've not been kissed in the past 5 years.
It's 2 weeks now, and that yaya guy never know what show.
Don't worry, that guy is gonna show.
In hell's name, when? Now when he want to show?
Huh? When he feels it's safe for him, he's gonna show up.
Ah. See, link on safe for me, I would dare want to do nanny job, eh?
Listen, that nanny job is probably what is keeping you alive.
See, I'm sick and tired of that little girl. The way the girl they talk to me, they make my head they vibrate.
Do not allow a little girl's sweet to overcome yours.
See, since the death of Zita,
Listen, Tiger. Zita, Mark, and Ludo, they were all pawns. They were used to smoke out Skippo. And now it is done. We have the ace. Okay? We have the ace. Right? We do not have to lose this game. We can never lose this game. If we carefully select our cards.
Wait. What the hell is this game all about? Am I going bananas?
Listen, you are going professional.
Professional?
Yes, that's right.
Nonsense. See, now me go kill you today, and I go kill you with this my hand. Come on, shut up there.
Do you ever look in a mirror?
I said shut up there before I bust your head.
I wonder how your mother felt when she gave birth to you.
I mean, they follow talking. Okay. You see, I'm going to kill you with this my hand.
If you try, I will kill you.
Me?
Don't worry. Then whatever you will meet. Tiger here.
Yeah? Yeah? Okay, no problem. You go say, I go show you, say, eh? I don't be your meat. I need you follow talk like that. I go kill you today. Now, today I go kill you. Come on, please. Come on!
Put me down!
Put me down!
Such a thing.
You need your man. I need the little girl.
What makes you think I need him?
Well, he wouldn't be too happy to hear that, would he?
Now listen, he has served his purpose. Okay? A pawn while I smoke you out. I don't even need him to kill the girl. But neither do I need him to put a bullet on your head.
So let the little girl go. We're pros, man. There are rules.
There are no rules. There are no rules. Who made the rules? God? Now listen to me, you ragging cockroach. There are no rules except the ones I make.
I'm a team player.
It's a game of cards, and all my cards are aces.
You sure about that?
Absolutely. Did you hear that?
Hey!
You're sitting between myself and my $200,000. And with that kind of money, I can even kill my own mother.
I didn't know you had a mother, man.
It's none of your business.
What do you want?
An exchange for the girl. You know what? You put your hands on your head and walk through Morocco Street. And remember, with the woman too.
Well, you must need the $200,000 pretty badly.
I'm a businessman.
He doesn't seem to think so highly about you.
Well?
Where? Son of a bitch. He wants a trade.
A trade? With what?
My life for hers.
How?
He wants me to walk with my hands on my head through the streets.
Son of a gun. So he'll kill you, kill me, and kill my daughter.
Am I glad you're thinking like a pro?
Mr. Skippo, on behalf of myself and my daughter, I want to say thank you for everything. You sure you don't want to change your mind?
Absolutely certain.
Have you ever heard of the word love?
You mean that mumbo jumbo found in the dictionary?
It's real. And I feel it now.
Well, all I feel right now is pity. Just go. Wait for 6 months and pick up the $5 million.
You've forgotten the conditions?
No, I haven't. But duty calls.
I love you, Skipper.
Thank you.
Thanks for saving my life, Uncle.
Me why you either ride or die. If I got to get to leave, is it a lie? Get to run, make a ride. Is it okay when pigeons are so sweet? I was tired many times to die. Watch my son below.
So,
nothing clear yet. But if it's unto us, I'm a pro. I can handle it.
Well, I told you he's not unto any of us.
Not my curse. He's either found, or he's either looking for a nightman or already found one.
Why are you so certain?
Because the man who ordered your father killed is not about to call it quits just because I'm protecting his daughter.
Isn't this so absurd?
What?
You killed my father, and here you are protecting me.
Please.
What?
Look, I'm only a pro doing my job.
Then why didn't you do the same job on me?
Don't push me.
Well, you think I care?
You don't give a damn if you care enough.
Then let me out of here. God! Why isn't anyone listening to me? I need to get back to the States.
Alright. I killed your father. But it's now my duty to protect you and Pretty. So, you don't move until I tell you to do so.
Just who the hell are you?
Mommy.
Sweetheart, you're awake. Hmm? Here we go. Kiss, kiss.
Superman, that's you, right? I got you, right? Drop that gun! Drop that shit! Superman! Your hands up? I want to see your hands up. Up! I said up!
Got a confirmation.
What confirmation?
There. He's got an assassin.
No.
One with a sniper's instinct and damn good.
So, how does he help?
Well, a great deal of knowing what we're up against is halfway through the problem, man.
So, what are we gonna do?
Leave here first, because he's a professional and he knows we're here ready.
What are we leaving for?
A safe place for at least 48 hours.
And after that?
Well, one at a time, okay? But first, I must find out who wants to kill me. Okay? Here, $50,000 ticket.
So, what do you want me to do? Kill my own mother?
I'm not that kind of a sucker. I know you killed your mother 25 years ago.
Hardly my fault.
Will you save your grief for another sucker?
So what do you want?
Marcus. Fred Marcus. He has a contract on my head. I want to know everything about the man on the job.
Who? That? Give me 2 minutes.
We gotta get better.
Then if it's that good, he will definitely find out this hideout.
That's exactly what I'm saying. We're moving out in 24 hours.
God! Why don't I just get off this dog chase and fly out with my daughter?
Because you're a target as much as I am. And for your information, they got $100,000 on our heads to knock us off.
Why are we sticking together anyway? It is good for you who can shoot back. But with my daughter, I am a sitting duck.
You are safe as long as I stay alive.
How?
Look, because you're a bait to smoke me out. In the professional handbook, that's what we do. We use the known to get to the unknown. You know what I'm saying? And I can go underground, you know, mix with the crowd and dissolve. But you can't.
Then let me fly out while you're still alive.
Come on, Mario. He's not a fool. Look, immediately you make that move, man, he's going to kill you, man, and come for me.
God, this is crazy.
I'll curse your luck for being the daughter of who you are.
Well, I don't care anymore.
Oh, you should. For your daughter's sake. Look, I'm only trying to help you, okay? So you better hang in there. I'm going to do something. I'm going to trap them all. One after the other. And kill them all. Alright, including Marcus. So, you wouldn't have to live in fear of the assassin's bullet anymore.
So, what do I do?
Whatever I tell you to.
And what exactly are you telling me to do?
Mariel, please, just go get some sleep, you know, relax, rest. You might not be as lucky as you are tomorrow night.
I hope you all know the caliber of a man we are up against. From now on, you have to be on your toes and constantly watch your backs. The element of surprise is gone forever. You take it from me. There are no more safety nets. We have lost Mark to a man we surprised.
I don't kill this woman, Tito. I don't know why you kick against her.
Now you listen to me and you listen good. This woman is the bait. You kill her and Skippo disappears. It comes back and pick each of you like pigeons. And guess what? It ends between us. So long as this woman is alive, he is potentially vulnerable.
So, make we just a Zuzu the follow up and down like that?
Exactly like you said. All we need to do is we have to strike him through her. First thing, we have to get his new abode. You feel me?
Come on in.
Come on.
Now sit.
Sit
down.
What was that just happened out there?
The amateur's instinct.
And who was in that car behind us?
Well, I paid him 50,000 naira.
To die?
Hazards of the profession.
God. Why did you do it?
What?
That's crazy stuff you call the amateur's instinct.
We are dealing with a professional who knows all the rules in the professional handbook. And to beat him, we need to use the amateur's instincts. Get it?
And what exactly does that mean?
Mariel, the amateur is one who does not know anything in the professional handbook. And does not play by the rules. Alright? I mean, he shoots when he shouldn't and runs when he should be still. Moving in a car in the dark with the lights on is a crazy thing to do. And no professional would employ that to duck a bullet from an assassin. Get it? And it worked.
Why are you doing this?
Because it's a game I enjoy. And besides, I owe you one.
That was crazy! That was completely useless! That was useless!
What's the problem?
He was using the amateur instincts.
Amateur instincts?
Yes, you heard me. Doing the unexpected. And that means playing with total disregard to the books.
In other words, being more professional, right? Now, what do we want to do now?
We smoke him! We smoke him out! Okay? So long as he keeps with the woman and the kid, he is vulnerable. Come on, let's get out. Come on, move it! Move it now!
down, put down, put down. Oh boy, dead!
Sorry, we have been here earlier, but for this heavy hold of 100.
Yeah, drink. Yeah. That's what you always do in my house. Drink. So, how is your assassin doing?
From every indication, he's covering grounds.
Covering grounds?
Sure.
By losing 2 men already.
Hazards of the profession. Camille is your best bet if you really want Skippo dead. Make no mistake about that.
You bet I do.
Then don't scare your blood vents. The man will surely deliver.
He better delivers. I'm getting very impatient.
He will.
That guy escaped for that hotel room.
I know.
You know?
Sure, Tiger, I know that.
How?
The professional instinct. Found only in the assassin's logbook.
What the hell is that son of a bitch?
I will soon find out.
I can't wait. We've lost Mark and Ludo. And the next person can be me.
Now you listen to me. You have survived. Okay? We are dealing with the best since the jackal. This guy is crafty. He read the books, he lives on trees, he lives on rooftops, and he has knocked more men than you've had quickies.
What did that guy come to say in himself? In a god?
It's the devil.
Okay, make what they see now.
So, why did we get this car?
Survival instincts.
Survival instinct?
That's right.
Obvious and draws a lot of attention.
Yeah, look, Camille will never look out for a car like this.
So, where are we going?
I'm taking the fight to him.
What?
That's right.
Then let me out of here.
Look, as long as you stay with me, you live.
I am no longer enjoying any bit of this.
God, no one enjoys war until you get entangled in it.
Why must we take the fight to him?
Because if we do not get him, he will get me and consequently you.
God.
What? He's got pity? God! No! Shh. No!
Calm down. Ah! Listen.
Jesus!
This can't be yours. This is smarter than I ever gave him credit for. God. The bastard has been reading me all along like a book. Listen, here, we're gonna get out of here right now. Come on, let's get out.
Let's check for.
Let's get out of here!
Let's check for. Come on! Let's go.
I beg, shop. You still get plenty days here.
I want to go home. I want to go home.
You don't get any house. So.
I'm risking your life for that.
You never know anything. No. How much longer do we wait? May I not call this job to come do Nani?
We're both going for him. He's going to be here and we get him.
So which time he won't come now?
He's a pro tiger. He's going to be here.
See, make I tell you. We don't miss Ludo and Mark. And the one with the payment pass now, Nazita. You know which are the thing?
That you are the next.
Bam!
You know what, Tiger? You play your role according to my script, and then you live to be 100 years.
So, waiting be the next scene for your script?
Waiting.
You got to do better than this, alright?
You know what, Tiger? I was taught waiting is the best form of suspense, and you better get that into your skull. Now, come on, you put some bullets into this shit, come on.
Go ahead, come on.
I only came here to bury Daddy. And got entangled in a web only formerly imagined in Hollywood screens.
Well, that's the life we live in, you know. Must always stop for true life stories.
So how do I get my daughter back?
Waiting.
Waiting?
Sure.
God, what if something happens to Pretty?
Nothing's gonna happen to her. She's now his trump card. He's gonna feed her well, pamper her, and expect me to make a quick grab at her.
But we must go for Pretty immediately.
That's what he expects us to do.
So? Why wait?
Because he's ready. Look. Waiting for me to make just that move. It's a mind game. Mariel, one slip, and there's no safety net.
So, what do we do?
Like I said, we wait.
Now tell me, why didn't you kill me when you already had the contract money?
I'd rather we skipped that.
No. If we have to wait this game out with my own daughter, as the bait around the hook dangling beneath the sinker, then we have to discuss it now.
Jesus! Please, please, please don't kill me, please. Please don't kill me, please. Please, please, my baby, please, please, please. Please save my baby, please. Please, please, please. Please. Jesus!
Jesus Christ!
Yeah. I went to Liberia, man, you know? I went to Liberia as a peacekeeper in the force, man. Well, my own family burned. I caught the animal. But because I wanted the Lord to take his course, I handed him over to the police. Otherwise, I would have killed that idiot with my bare hands.
This is
the same government I went thousands of miles away to serve, collaborating with a gunman to wipe away my own direct family.
The government?
Yeah, sure. The killing was political. My father, he got in the way, so it was time to pay back.
This is unbelievable.
I know, but it's true. Immediately, I picked up my rifle and became an assassin. I got all of them involved, including the judge, and I knocked them all off.
But two wrongs don't make a right.
But anyway, I became a professional hitman. Because I lost my own family, man. Damn. My source of joy. My source of joy. Nothing mattered to me anymore.
But two wrongs can't make a right.
That's theoretical. In real life, vengeance can be soothing.
So,
that night, when I had my rifle pointed at you, the sudden appearance of your daughter changed everything. At that moment, it dawned on me like my family 5 years ago that you and your daughter needed protection. So, I employed myself.
Damn! You're one hell of a gunman.
You're one hell of a daughter. And tell me, why would your father come in the crosshairs of my sniper's telescope?
It's a long story.
Oh, well, we got all night. Listen, why don't you tell me, why would you entrust yourself to a man who killed your father to protect you?
The last bit is simple. I saw you squeeze the trigger and pop the bullet over my head. It was a gamble I had to take. Not that I had a choice, though, with the other group itching dangerously close.
It was a matter of convenience, is it?
More or less.
Or no, I'm listening.
Yes, Maria. I called you because I want to let you into one secret.
What secret, Daddy?
$50 million. A certain $50 million.
$50 million?
Yes. But I have a partner. A partner in crime, you may call it.
What are you saying? A partner in crime?
You don't seem to understand why our economy is crumbling every day, do you?
It's obvious. Mismanagement, of course.
My daughter, looting is the appropriate word.
So what happened to the $50 million?
Yes, I was working as an accountant.
But Daddy, that was years ago.
Yes, precisely 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
There was this supplier and general contractor. But before that time, the chief executive of NEPA went by the name Marcos. As is usual in government agencies, we struck a deal and faked some invoices and wired $50 million to a pre-numbered account in Zurich.
What?
Yes, but the SSS got nosy and asked some questions. So we decided to stay action. We instructed the Swiss bank through our agents here, the Ultimate Bank, to stay action. Both of us devised a secret code, not known to each one of us. And we have to feed this secret code into the computer every month. And in the event of one becoming dormant, the other person takes over.
Why such absurd agreement?
My daughter, one has to agree to something.
So?
It was a sworn secret between Marcos and me. You see, Marcos has no relations, and he believes I don't have one either.
In other words, you deceived him.
Yes, because he wouldn't have done the business with me in the first place.
So why tell me now after 10 years?
Yes. You see, Marcos is in the hole. His business has beaten the dust.
and he wants to grab the money. I've been holding him back all this while because this is just one move that the SSS are waiting for.
I don't understand. Why corner such amount of money when you cannot even spend it?
One, it gives you a great sense of pleasure to know that you have such amount of money, even if you can't spend it. Secondly, I mean, a friendly government may come up one day and the SSS may decide to look the other way. I'm an accountant, mind you, never in a hurry.
In the meantime,
Marcus is desperate. He wants to kill me and inherit the account in the event of my inactivity for 6 months.
So, how do you intend to stop him?
Yes, by giving you the secret code which you must feed into the computer every first Monday of every month in case if anything happens to me.
So, you provided the bullets?
Well, hardly my fault. I mean, I was only a professional trying to earn a living.
No grudges. My father lived a risky life. He was expecting it anyway.
So, who's Brady's father? And you married? Divorced?
None of your business.
Forgive me.
Please.
What?
I've not been kissed in the past 5 years.
Now, and that yaya guy never know one show.
Don't worry, Tiger is gonna show.
In hell's name, when? Now when he won't show?
Huh? When he feels it's safe for him, he's gonna show up.
Ah. See, Link can't say for me, I would dare want to do nanny job, eh?
Listen, that nanny job is probably what is keeping you alive.
See, I'm sick and tired of that little girl. The way the girl they talk to me, they make my head they vibrate.
Do not allow a little girl sweet to overcome you.
See, since the death of Zita, I...
Listen, Tiger. Zita, Mark, and Ludo, they were all pawns. They were used to smoke out Skippo. And now it is done. We have the ace. Okay? We have the ace. Right? We do not have to lose this game. We can never lose this game. If we carefully select our cards.
Wait. What the hell is this game all about? Am I going bananas?
Listen, you are going professional.
Professional?
Yes, that's right.
See, Nami go kill you today, and I go kill you with this my hand. Come on, shut up there.
Do you ever look in a mirror?
I said shut up there before I bust your head.
I wonder how your mother felt when she gave birth to you.
I mean, you follow talking. Okay. You see, I'm going to kill you with this my hand.
If you try, I will kill you.
Me?
Don't worry. Then whatever you be with.
Tiger here.
Yeah? Okay, no problem. You go say, I go show you, say, eh? I don't be your meat. I need.
Where's the girl? Move! Stay there! Don't move back! Where's the girl?
Car's late.
We should see. Where's the girl? Where is the girl?
I said you're late.
You've got my man? Huh?
Are you the little girl I'm supposed to protect?
Nothing personal.
I said we trade then.
And what makes you think I'm gonna do such a thing?
You need your man. I need the little girl.
What makes you think I need him?
Well, he wouldn't be too happy to hear that, would he?
Now listen, he has served his purpose. Okay? A pawn while I smoke you out. I don't even need him to kill the girl. Or neither do I need him to put a bullet on your head.
So let the little girl go. We're pros, man. There are rules.
There are no rules. There are no rules. Who made the rules? God? Now listen to me, you rotten cockroach. There are no rules except the ones I make.
I'm a team player.
It's a game of cards, and all my cards are aces.
You sure about that?
Absolutely. Did you hear that?
Hey!
You're sitting between myself and my $200,000. And with that kind of money, I can even kill my own mother.
I didn't know you had a mother, man.
It's none of your business.
What do you want?
An exchange for the girl. You know what? You put your hands on your head and walk through Morocco Street. And remember, with the woman too.
Well, you must need the $200,000 pretty badly.
I'm a businessman.
He doesn't seem to think so highly about you.
Well?
Where? Son of a bitch. He wants a trade.
A trade? With what?
My life for hers.
How?
Wants me to walk with my hands on my head through the streets.
Son of a gun. So he'll kill you, kill me, and kill my daughter.
Am I glad you're thinking like a pro?
Mr. Skippo, on behalf of myself and my daughter, I want to say thank you for everything. You sure you don't want to change your mind?
Absolutely certain.
Have you ever heard of the word love?
You mean that mumbo jumbo found in the dictionary?
It's real. And I feel it now.
Well, all I feel right now is pity. Just go. Wait for 6 months and pick up the $5 million.
You've forgotten the conditions?
No, I haven't. But duty calls.
I love you, Skipper.
Thank you.
Thanks for saving my life, Uncle.
Thank you, bringing back beautiful memories.
I love you, Uncle.
Crazy idea was a flop after all.
You don't say that, Marcus. It is not yet over until...
Seems your crazy idea was a flop after all.
You don't say that, Marcus. It is not yet over until it is all over.
I'm talking about.
Right, you are.
Skippo, what is it? No, put away that thing. Put that thing. Put it away.
No.
Skippo. Listen. Skippo. Skippo. Let us negotiate.
I do not negotiate with the cops.
Skippo, please, don't shoot.
The game is kinda the stakes so high.